this spot's been on our radar forever. We knew we could not let another Italian episode get by without stopping at Freddy's. We're in the boss's old neighborhood of Bridgeport. Let's go get our eat on and free parking.
For over two decades, Freddy's fresh Italian aroma has been drawing in the masses to their corner spot. But it's more than just their home cooking that keeps patrons coming back.
The Petrucci family, they're good people.
You can come in once a month and you feel like you were here yesterday.
You got to know these people like they're your old family.
Even if you're not part of the neighborhood, when you come here, you feel like you are.
It's just like a mainstay. It's part of my life.
So it's all in the family in this
all
restaurant.
All in the family. It's a family-oriented restaurant. We encourage families to come because we make our sausage from scratch. We make our meatballs, our soups, and our sauces are all homemade.
You definitely cannot beat the homemade factor. So rumor has it, you guys make a killer meatball, and Mark from Facebook actually said we have to come here to check it out.
It's my mother's old recipe, down in the family.
Well, I think it's time to start cooking.
Sounds good to me.
It's meatball time, so let's get to it. What is the secret ingredient in these things?
Most people put breadcrumbs, but that makes the meatballs hard and dry. We take old Italian bread and we soak it in water. This is a mixture of half ground pork, half beef.
And in case you didn't know down there, fat equals flavor. So the more fat we're putting in there with pork, it's gonna be fantastic. You like bacon, right? Why wouldn't you love these?
Now it's time for the seasoning. Denise dumps in the garlic, salt, pepper, and a mound of Romano cheese.
I'm not gonna lie, it's a little bit more difficult to mix in there.
When it's dry, it's a lot easier.
We finish the batch off with some parsley and, of course, a few eggs to help the meat stick together when we start rolling them up.
How are we looking? Is this good?
It's good.
I'm ready to start forming these things, right? Do this.
Grab a bunch.
So how much is a bunch?
Yeah, well, you know, we give our customers, most of our portions are pretty big.
Pop them in the oven at how high?
350 degrees for about 30, 40 minutes.
While those are in the oven, I'm gonna go downstairs. I'm gonna find out what everyone else is grubbing on. Are you cool with that?
Sounds good to
awesome.
Me.
Let's go.
Food's phenomenal.
I like the Italian sausage, pizza.
Breaded steak, I just had that today, actually.
And meatball sandwich.
I'll come down here and get the beef sandwich every time, but I have to leave with the Italian ice.
Come down from Kenosha, Wisconsin.
Coming from all the way from Blue Island.
We make it a day. You got a Sox game in the evening, so I mean, why tailgate when you can come here?
It's the best of the best.
The best.
Best food in the world.
So your shirt says Freddie Knows Beef, and you just hit us with the Bridgeport triple play. What is all this?
This is a combo.
I see two sausages in there?
Oh yeah, we were known before as the home of the double sausage. This is a breaded steak. And the meatballs, we showed you how to do those.
Yeah, and the meatballs are so big, they slice them into thirds. And because she doesn't want to measure anything, that's my win, so let's get in it.
They're messy, but they're good.
It's very juicy. You know, I think that bread obviously brings a lot of things to life, so clearly I've witnessed it. But why are you Chicago's
best? Old-time Italian family recipes. Everything's homemade, family all does it, we all work together. Makes it special.
Obviously, the portion size is gigantic. And if you have a restaurant for us, be sure to hit us up at chicagosbesttv.com or on Facebook and Twitter.